I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that he is with me every day. He's by my side, he hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in him. I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the watching over me. He keeps me safe, he loves my family. Jesus, I trust.
Hey Willard, and guess what? It's a beautiful day again.
Oh, it is a beautiful day, but I wish I wasn't all tangled up.
Oh, Oh boy, how did you do that?
Well, I was trying to untangle the yarn so that I could make some fun crafts with it, but then my tail got stuck in the pile of yarn, and when I went to start untangling it, it was all over me.
Wow, Willard, you're kind of in a mess here. Let me help you free you from that. All right, here we got it.
Oh, that feels so much better.
I bet it does.
Kyle, I heard you use a word that I don't think I really know. It was free. What does that mean, Kyle?
Well, free means to no longer be trapped by something. So, Willard, you were trapped by all that yarn. It was all over you. And when we got it off of you, you were free. It wasn't stopping you anymore.
Oh, wow. I learned in church that God sets us free from our sins, the bad things that we do.
Yes, he does. When we do bad things or sin, we can talk to God and ask for his forgiveness. And God forgives us. He sets us free. Hey, let's all say our special one thing together. God's power sets me free. You ready?
God's power sets me free.
But how does that work? How does God and his power set me free?
Well, God sent his son Jesus to earth so that he could die and rise again 3 days later. And he did this so that we could have a really good friendship with God. And God forgives us when we say that we're sorry. He sets us free.
Wow, God must really love us.
He sure does. We just have to make him the leader of our lives. You know, we should learn about how amazing and powerful God really is.
That sounds like a good plan.
And hey, we can learn more about Moses. We learned about him last week.
Oh yeah, his story was crazy so far. I bet we can learn even more about God's power and how he can set us free. Let's go find out.
Hey everyone, it's me, Steve. Last week we talked about how God had an amazing plan for Moses, and God has an amazing plan for each of us. I'm sure you guys already know just how great and powerful God is, but let's look at Moses' story for a really cool example. Do you remember what happened with Moses last week? God appeared to him in a burning bush. Can you imagine a bush on fire talking to you? It was crazy! And God told Moses that he wanted his help to free the Hebrew people from Egypt. And if anyone can free the people, it's God, because he's so powerful. That's our special one thing today. God's power sets me free. Let's all say our special one thing together, everyone. Ready? God's power sets me free. So, Moses needs to go talk to the Pharaoh. He was the king of all of Egypt. Do you think that Pharaoh will be nice to Moses and let the Hebrews go? God told Moses that Pharaoh would not let the people go. Let's read our story from Exodus, which is in the Old Testament of the Bible, and find out. Then the Lord said to Moses, Pharaoh's heart is stubborn, and he still refuses to let the people go. Then announce to him, The Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has sent me to tell you, let my people go, so they can worship me in the wilderness. God gave Moses a really big job to talk to Pharaoh, but we see that Pharaoh still would not let the people go. God then told Moses that he would send plagues to Egypt until the Pharaoh agreed to let the people leave. We can call these plagues miracles because they show us just how powerful God is. Oh, and remember, God's power sets me free. Let's all say that together, everyone. Ready? God's power sets me free. There were 10 plagues or miracles. 1. God turned the river into blood. 2. God sent frogs to be everywhere. 3. God sent gnats to be everywhere. 4. God sent flies to be everywhere. 5. The Egyptians' cows and sheep and other livestock died. 6. People got boils all over them. Boils are kind of like ouchies. 7. God sent a ton of hail. 8. God sent locusts to be everywhere and eat their crops. 9. God sent darkness to cover the land. But still, the Pharaoh would not let the people leave. That's when God made the last plague, number 10. It was called the Passover. God gave the Hebrew people special rules to follow. The Hebrews who loved and worshipped God obeyed him and sacrificed the young animals just as he instructed. Then they spread the blood on the doorposts of their houses. This event is called Passover because God's Spirit passed over the homes of those who loved, worshipped, and obeyed Him. Everyone else who didn't know God and obeyed Him lost the firstborn son in their family. It was really sad. But for the Hebrews, it was good because it showed God's power and how He would set them free. Pharaoh finally had enough and told Moses to leave with all the Hebrews. God's power set them free! God's power sets me free! Let's all say our special one thing together, everyone. Ready? God's power sets me free! God loves us all very much because we are all His children. He would do a lot for us. He sent His one and only Son to save us from all our sins. That's Jesus! It was a huge sacrifice for Him to make. When Jesus died on the cross for us, His blood was spilled so that we would be forgiven and God could pass over our sins. God wants to always forgive us, but we have to ask Him for forgiveness when we do wrong or we sin. And because of Jesus' sacrifice on the cross for us, God sets us free from the punishment that we deserve. God's power sets me free. Let's all say that together, everyone. Ready? God's power sets me free! This week, I want you to look for God's power. Maybe you see a really strong storm and you think about how powerful God is to make that thunder so loud. Or maybe you feel really brave one day and you make a new friend who you were scared to talk to. And you remember that God's power helped you be brave. And always remember that God loves you so much that He set you free from the punishment of the sin or the bad things that we do. I'll see you all next week, everyone. Bye!
Wow! God is so powerful! He made all those plagues, and He set His people free!
Yes, He did! And the most amazing part is that when we make Him the leader of our lives, He sets us free from the punishment of our sins or the bad things that we do. He forgives us!
Oh, but Kyle, what if I do something wrong?
Well, then we just have to talk to God and tell Him that we're sorry about it, and He forgives us! He sets us free.
Oh, He really loves all of us, doesn't He?
He does. Hey, let's all say our special one thing together. God's power sets me free. You ready? God's power sets me free.
I'm so glad that God forgives me and sets me free. He's so powerful. Kyle, will you pray with me so that we can thank God for loving us so much?
Of course. You guys ready? Let's go ahead and pray. Dear God, You have such an amazing power. Thank You so much for loving me and giving me Your Son, Jesus.
Amen.
Hey kids, I'm Hannah. Before we end today, let's practice our memory verse and pray. No one will be able to stand against you as long as you live. For I will be with you as I was with Moses. I will not fail you or abandon you. Joshua 1 verse 5. Let's all say, God's power sets me free. Ready? God's power sets me free. Let's all pray. Put your hands together and bow your head. Dear God, thank You for giving Your Son, Jesus, for me. I know that You will always love me. Amen. Bye, guys. Have a wonderful week.